Hi everybody, Kayla here, and today I want to chat a little bit with you about this idea of finding comfort in the uncomfortable. This is something that I chat a lot about with to my athletes, as well as something that I chat with myself about often, and something that I strive really hard to do as an athlete myself. As with race season really ramping up, a lot of us are either in our final builds to our first race, or maybe we're just starting a really big build for our first race, because we've got a lot of spring races. I mean, we've got Galveston 70.3 coming up, we've got Texas Full coming up, as well as Santa Cruz, St. George, even Boulder. 140.6 is really not that far away, as well as their race season has already started if you're living in Australia and stuff like that. So I think even New Zealand might be this weekend. So this idea of finding comfort in the uncomfortable is really prevalent right now, because we're going to start having to get a little bit uncomfortable. Our training's going to ramp up, our volume's going to ramp up, and all these pieces are going to start ramping up. So you have to learn how to be uncomfortable with uncomfortable. Triathlon is all about, quote unquote, embracing the suck, and how much, quote unquote, suck it is that you can embrace. And so I kind of want to chat with you about this. I did a blog post on my five tips for finding comfort in the uncomfortable a little while back, and I just want to share those tips with you on this platform. So it's kind of intuitive, this idea of finding comfort in the uncomfortable, but really what I'm getting at is this idea of stepping outside of your comfort zone a little bit more. All of us have this comfort zone that we've built up that is our own little protective bubble, and our bodies and our minds and our emotions create this comfort zone to keep us safe. And the second we start to step outside of that comfort zone, our body goes, no, our brain goes, no. You need to get back in that comfort zone so that you can stay safe. We want to keep you safe. But really, as you step outside of that comfort zone, you start to expand the boundaries of it. And as you expand the boundaries of that comfort zone, then your abilities and your opportunities and what you're willing to maybe put yourself through a little bit more, that expands as well. And so by having what I like to say is 15 seconds of courage to step outside of that comfort zone and expand that boundary just a little bit, this comfort with that uncomfortable action is what really helps us to grow. And honestly, that's what triathlon is all about. That is why I got into it, is because I needed something to push myself outside my comfort zone to learn a little bit more about me. And this is what we learn more. It's more, to me, triathlon is more than just this physical feat. It's really about how far we can push those boundaries and what we learn about ourselves through them. So anyways, how is it that you can kind of start this process of stepping outside of your comfort zone? Really, the number one thing is just do it. Get started with it. And this is honestly probably one of the hardest steps, because maybe it is that you've already recognized that you need to step outside of your comfort zone, but it can be really, really difficult to take that first step and do it, because it's scary, it's hard, it's probably going to hurt. And so you just have to make this decision, and you have to commit to this decision and know that there is no going back once you do. And once you've kind of come to this conclusion and you really embrace this conclusion and embrace this idea that you are committing to it and you're up for it and you're going to do it, then that step becomes a lot easier and you can really take that next step and you can kind of go with it. The next piece is, again, to embrace the suck. Realistically, this is just another way to say don't quit. But really this idea of embracing the suck and this thought process of not just doing something to do something, but really opening your arms, opening your heart, and embracing what it is that you're doing. And so that suck or discomfort is here to actually make you stronger. It's here to make you better. It's here to make you more mentally tough. It's basically here to make you tougher. And by embracing that suck, all you're doing is embracing the challenge and the uncomfortableness that you're going to face throughout those challenges. So celebrate it. Celebrate the fact that you're embracing it, and celebrate the suck almost as a blessing rather than a curse, because you know that you're not going to let it beat you. You're going to come out stronger in the end. The other one I wanted to say when it comes to this idea of finding comfort in the uncomfortable is through recognizing your improvements. So tracking your progress as you're going through it. So a lot of times we are our own worst critics, and we more often than not we say something and unless we don't physically see it, we don't actually full on embrace it or believe that it actually happened. And so by tracking this progress, this allows you to really see the growth within that step. This is something that having a coach actually can really help you with, because they're the ones to be able to track your progress. They can see your progress. And they're also that third party person who's going to say, when you're telling them that you sucked, they're going to say, hey, actually, last week you couldn't hold that 85% effort for more than 2 minutes. This week you held that 85% effort for 5 minutes. That is a big improvement. That is an improvement. That is something to recognize, and that is something to celebrate. So recognize your improvements. It reminds you of where you started, why you started, and how far you've come. It can be a huge confidence booster, and that confidence is what then makes that bubble, that comfort bubble, a little bit bigger. The last one that I really want to chat with you about is repetition. It's this idea of consistency. So the more that you perform the same activity, the more that you step outside your comfort zone, the more confident you become, the more your body has a muscle memory to it, and the more that muscle you can remind yourself that it's already done this, it can adapt to the uncomfortable. And so the next time, it's not going to be as uncomfortable. Our bodies are amazing, amazing things. They do not want to go through the same thing that you went through last time. So it's going to adapt to it. And that's why we become stronger, is because our bodies say, ooh, you put us through something really hard a week ago, and you're trying to do it again, but I'm stronger this time, so I'm not going to let you beat me. Repetition, consistency, staying on top of it, staying with it. These are all the things that are going to really help you to increase and move that comfort zone and make being comfortable with the uncomfortable a lot easier. So I hope this really helps you to maybe step outside your comfort zone a little bit. And if you have, you know, if it's something that you're wanting to chase and a dream you're wanting to chase, I say go for it. Take that leap, take that step. I know for me, triathlon was that step, and it could be, maybe it's running for you that we're talking about, or maybe it's a business venture that you're wanting to start. Whatever it is that is making you nervous, but is not something that you can let go of, it's something that you think about on a daily basis, constantly, never ending, then that means that it is something that is really important to you. And so despite it being uncomfortable, you need to go for it. So I hope you guys maybe can find a little bit of comfort in finding in the uncomfortable, and really use it to go after and chase your dreams. Because let me tell you, when you do, it is all worth it.